If you're planning a move and you're wondering if Viera is the right place for you to go, well, in this video, I'm going to cover 6 pros and cons to help you with that decision right after this. My name is Eric Larkin. I'm with RE/MAX Aerospace, and I do regular videos just like this one talking about living, working, playing, and of course, real estate here in Brevard County in the Space Coast. If this is something that you're interested in, you should probably hit that subscribe button and ring the bell so you're notified every time I put up new videos just like this one. And if you are moving either into the Space Coast or you're moving out of our area, I'm sure that you have questions. Well, I get questions from folks just like you every day that I love to answer, and I'd love to hear from you too. You could either call me, you can text me, you can comment below. You can hunt me down on social media and send me a direct message. However you like to communicate, I'm great with. Let's get on with the pros and cons of living in Viera. So every place you live has its pros and cons of living there. And in this video, I'm going over the 6 topics I'd like to cover you about Viera. And you probably want to stick around to the end because that's the most controversial one that can swing you one way or another. First thing I want to talk to you about is the age of the homes. Viera is one of the newest communities we have here in Brevard County. Viera started in the late 1980s. Most of the homes in East Viera were built between 1990 and the early 2000s. And West Viera, they started building there late 1990s and really blew up with their construction in 2000. And they're still building new construction today in West Viera. All the homes in Viera are on city water and sewer, so you don't have to worry about septic tanks. Most of the homes were built after 2002, so you have better hurricane standards on the construction, which means a safer home and lower insurance costs. Because it's newer construction, you don't have to worry about some of the things you get in the older homes, like aluminum wiring, Federal Pacific electrical panels, and cast iron pipes. There is one thing you need to be concerned with if you are looking at some of the homes built in 1990 in East Viera. There's a couple sections that have found polybutylene plumbing during home inspections, and if you come across that, that's something that'll need to be addressed. The good thing is, it's fixable. Viera is located in the center of Brevard County, so you're in a great central location. You have 4 access points to get you to I-95, which is easy access to get anywhere in the county. Also have some easy access points to get to US-1, again, easy access to get anywhere in the county. With the newer communities, that means you have newer shops, you have newer restaurants, you have newer schools for the kiddos. You've got the Health First Hospital that's out there, plus there's a lot of doctors and medical facilities that you can find in Viera as well. If you love to golf, Viera was made for you. There's golf courses throughout the community of Viera, plus within a short drive, there's 6 or 7 other golf courses you can enjoy. Lots of great outdoor activities that you can have in Viera. You've got all the paths and walkways and parks that are inside the communities. You have the Viera wetlands you can enjoy, and the Brevard County Zoo also has the Linear Park. Because you're located on the mainland and you're also west of US-1, you don't have to worry about evacuating during a storm. If you are wanting to get to the beach is about 20 minutes away. A couple of cons about living in Viera. One, you're not that close to the beach. So if you wanted to be able to grab your bike and ride to the beach, you're gonna have to drive in order to do that. Another thing, if you're looking to get a home that's on the water, if you want river access or canal access that'll take you to the intercoastal, since Viera is located west of US-1, you don't have those opportunities. Viera's got some traffic. There along Wickham Road near 95 going either direction, it gets bottlenecked pretty quickly, especially during rush hour. If you are going anywhere near the baseball facilities, if there's an event going on, traffic gets kind of thick, and especially around the holidays, the avenues of Viera gets rather busy too. There's also the roundabout, that traffic circle. I get white knuckled every time I drive through there. But some of the good things about what Viera has set up are the extra access points that have recently opened up. You have the Viera Boulevard that goes over 95 and the diverging Diamond Interchange, which really helps with traffic flow. And they are soon to be opening up an access point the south of Viera that'll get you connected to the Pineta Causeway and the 404, which will definitely open up traffic options in the Viera area. They allow golf carts in Viera. If you like the idea of taking the kids to school or picking them up from school, you can do that in your golf cart. And every time I go to one of the Publixes in Viera, I always see a golf cart there too. Now keep in mind, you can't drive your golf cart on any of the roadways that are over 30 miles an hour, and they will not allow golf carts on Wickham Road, on Pineda Causeway, or on Viera Boulevard. Your property taxes living in Viera are some of the lowest in the county. You're either in the Rockledge unincorporated or you're in Melbourne unincorporated, and the millage rate for both areas are $13.20. It's that number there. How does that compare to the city of Rockledge? City of Rockledge's millage rate is $17.2908, and the city of Melbourne has $18.1189. Taxes in the Viera area are much lower than the neighbors inside the city limits right next door. There are parts of Viera that have a community development district, also known as a CDD. This is a long-term bond that the developers took out in order to put the infrastructure into these communities. And it'll show up on your tax bill as a non-ad valorem tax, and it'll be there for 50 years or more, depending on when they renew it. But it's something to keep in mind if you are looking in the Viera area to see if there is a CDD on your tax bill and if that's something that's important to you or not. I've got a link below to show you what the East Viera CDD looks like. The one important thing I need to tell you about with Viera, or talk to you about Viera. Viera is considered a master planned community, which is also known as a homeowners association. So if you don't like the idea of living in an HOA and having rules to live by and somebody telling you what you can do, you shouldn't even consider Viera. But with that in mind, homeowners associations actually can be a good thing. Yes, there are rules living in an HOA and standards you need to abide by with the upkeep of your home, but keep in mind, so do your neighbors, and that could be a blessing in disguise. Besides having the rules that you need to follow, a lot of the homeowners associations also have some fantastic amenities. There could be community pools, tennis courts, basketball courts, parks for you to enjoy, along with all the paths and walkways throughout Viera as a community. As you can see, Viera does have its pros and cons. And if you don't like the idea of living in a homeowners association, then maybe Viera is not the right place for you. But I believe its pros have a lot for you to offer and something that you should consider. And if you are planning a move somewhere here in Brevard County, I think you should definitely look in to see what Viera has to offer. Do you have any questions about Viera? Do you have any questions about a move somewhere here in Brevard County? You know you can call me, you can text me, you can comment below. And if you have stuck around this long, you probably like this video. And if you haven't done so already, you should definitely hit that subscribe button. Plus, I've queued up two more videos for you to watch next. My name is Eric Larkin with RE/MAX Aerospace. I appreciate you tuning in. I'll see you on the next show.